go up there and we put the flag in our field, it's going to represent the commitment that every single one of us have made.
I didn't choose him. The players chose him. Kyle, too, is a tremendous, tremendous worker, tremendous person. Is working on the scout team as a fifth-year senior. Has already graduated and just is a great example. And the players respect him because of his effort and his hard work, and they selected him to carry the flag out today. It wasn't my choice. But I think they chose wisely.
It represents success. And the flag represents that return to success. It represents the transition of him becoming our head coach.
So we don't take it lightly. So when we represent that, we represent that symbol, we represent that stadium, and then the name LaVell Ewards, and those type of things, we don't take those things lightly.
If we do do the haka, it's just letting the opponent know that we're ready to get ready for battle, that we're here to fight, and let them know that they better be ready through the first hit and last.
It's part of our new identity. It symbolizes us preparing ourselves to go to war.
And I feel the exact same now as I would if I would have been just coaching one unit. I coached the entire unit, and we were all in it together, and we didn't perform at a high enough level today to win the game. And that's what I'm expected to do, and I came up short. In terms of being how I'm judged is by the wins. What I mentioned during the week is what I cared about most is to have them completely invested in our cause and physically spent going up the ramp and completely committed in that way. And I think it's a starting point there as well. They have a baseline established, and now there's a clear reference point on truly where we are after working against someone else besides ourselves. And it's my job now to, with this coaching staff, diagnose exactly what the areas are that need improvement, the players that need improvement, and the areas of game management that can be handled better, and then we move forward.
It is shocking. Our offense is, dang it, we're better than that. And we all know it, to where it's just horrible that we were killing ourselves like that. We should have done a whole lot better.
Well, anytime you know you start a new offense, you know, you have to kind of give and take a little. You know, you're going to make a few mistakes, obviously. But overall, we just didn't execute.
Well, we can't get discouraged. Obviously, we're disappointed in ourselves because we know that we can be a high-powered offense. We can score points. Today, you know, we move the ball great, and then all of a sudden we do something that shot us in the foot. So we can't go into this next week being discouraged. We have to be upbeat, find the things that we made mistakes on, fix them, and go into this ball game fired up. I mean, we came out fired up today. We came out, things rolling. We just need to keep that going. So no way can we be discouraged by any means. We have to be disappointed in how we performed, but correct our mistakes, get back out on the practice field, and make ourselves that much better for next week's games.
I hope the fans don't bail on us. We played hard tonight or today, and there was a lot of, if you look closely, there was a lot of good things that were done. Like I said before, we need to tighten up some of the loose ends, and I think when that happens, people are going to see some big things happen with BYU football, because we got the personnel, and we got a good offense, and things start rolling. They're going to start rolling. You guys will see.
This is the first step. I mean, we can talk about how great we're going to be and things like that, and how good we're going to be tonight or today. Now we see how good we are. We know we have our starting point, and our destination is still Mountain West Conference Championship, a bowl game. And this hasn't held us back from reaching that destination. We just have to focus and eliminate the mistakes.
I'm positive about it. I'm positive. I thought we played all right. There were a few key coverage mistakes we made. We have our man. It's a perfect call for the play they're running. And we didn't execute, and that's what it came down to. There were three or four times where our coverage, just a guy misses responsibility, and that led to a touchdown. I mean, they ran the ball too much on us. We're going to work on that. But, I mean, I saw a lot of positive things, a lot of things we can work on. But I'm excited to see how this team responds and how we come out Monday. But I'm excited, positive.